Hey folks, this is Noble Rambler, and welcome back to another episode of Farming Simulator 17. We're in Goldcrest Valley, and we are still harvesting sugar beets. And just turned the game on, so I've got to turn this guy back on again to get him finishing his job. Also the cultivator out there. And what are we going to plant in here? Now think about that. Let's hire him and eject, and I'm in his way. There we go. Here's that one. I didn't check to see. Was he empty? I think he's empty. So we have three quarters of a row to go. Let's get him going, and then let's think about what we want to plant in here. We cannot afford sunflowers. We don't have the ability to do corn. That didn't work. Let's back up a bit just to make sure there's no chance of missing a little segment. Higher, jump out. There you go. Okay. He stopped. He's backing up. Because of things. Yeah, let's take the headland off of this one too. And unhire. Run out over here. Take a couple of these off. And while we're at it, let's see if I can do this with my mouse. Let's snag this one little guy left over here. Waste not, want not. Okay. Fire, we going? And we're on the ground? Yeah, we are. But we'll clip off three or four of these rows. The sign or the trees or something was causing them to delay there. That should be enough right in there. And then I'm going to start him back up on this side, so he can be working on the side that the cultivator is working toward. Maybe we can still... Oh, that's right, I'm not doing that yet, though. So I gotta finish these. Alright, we're just gonna write our name in the crop field here. Make some crop circles. Yeah, great big N right there in the middle. That'd make a good screenshot, wouldn't it? Okay, get those wheels over there. There we go. Are we full before we finish this little area? Oh, we are full. Ah, boy. Okay, well, let's get into position for the next one. Hit the, I assume it's O. Yep. And, yep, I'm way up there. I'm just going to do that. Great. Bring him over. Yeah, we're racing against cultivator there. Probably have to turn him off for a while, or we can bring him over to this side when he gets too close. Yeah, we can do that. Good? That's good. Yeah. Whoa. Meant to go... Nope, not gonna let me look in there. Okay. Let's put him... I guess over here... Something like that. Hop out. Let's finish this one. Let's see. That one. And that one. Alright, now we look like we know what we're doing. Not really. Alright, let's finish writing her name in the crop field here. There. There. Now, can I? I cannot. Okay. Where'd I put that other one? Right there. Okay, line him back up. It's probably close enough. Higher out. Eject. There we go. All right. And G is blocked. That's by me. Okay, I'm an object. Now let's go and empty him out one last time to kind of fill up the last little bit of our trailer here. We'll dump him. And then, oh man, too close to the edge. Oh well, we're going to just ignore that. And he's on the other side, isn't he? Darn. Alright, let's see if we can just do this manually. Yeah, about there. Done. Oh, yeah, that drives me nuts. That the output there swings into the path. Regular harvesters, it's out over the top. Never make contact. Oh, well. That's what the insurance company's for. Let's go dump this. Now, what seed goes in there? Back this in, and while it's dumping, we'll pop up the other screen and see if we can figure it out. Alright, let's see. Where do I want to go with this? Let's take it just around into there, like that. Yeah, we can go a little further. Alright. Well, it's been a while. Was it Y? It was... Oh, it was Control-I. That's right. Left Control-I, too. They picked the one that's the furthest away. There it is. Now, let's go forward a little bit. And... let's look at this. Alright, so sweet potatoes, where it's being dumped, we're not going to get a count. So, we're just going to assume we have gobs. G-O-B-S, gobs. Liters. Gob liters. 32,000, 29, 27, 29, 34. Let's go with canola. We haven't done that crop for a while. I wanted to last time and realized the big sower didn't have it. It did the soy. So let's get the little sower out and do canola. Yep, I like that. Alright, you're good. You're good. Grain tank is full. So we're not going to be getting it out right now. And I've got to Control-I again. When you dump it at a silo, it automatically closes for you. When you dump it here, you have to do it manually. Alright, where's he at? He's right over there. Gotta get him out of there before that cultivator catches up. And this time we're going to let him pull away. No, I don't know what we're going to do. Because he starts closing it down long before we're out of his way, his path. I guess I'm just going to floor it and try to get out of there in time. Yeah, that's kind of awkward. Now we can be at the back end of the trailer here. That'll help. Something like that. And where am I not in everybody's way? Right over here. Okay, let's get a sower. Make sure there's fertilizer and seed in it, which means I need a tractor. Those two are in there. He's here. Where's the other case? I don't remember. Oh, the other case is on the trailer. That's right. Okay. And we're going to drop this guy. I've got fuel. So he's the little one in the back there. About there. Yeah. And we look like we're pretty full. Just looking in the bins right there. So we'll call that good. Let's get him out of here. We'll start him right here where it's easy. There we go. Okay. Ah, this time it's Y. That's canola. I'm gonna run through the cycle there. Yeah. All right, hire you out. Jump out of here. You look happy. Let's get ready to dump this guy one more time. Nobody driving on our private road here. And his beacons are on. Let's see if I can catch him this way. Ah, okay, full tank. Yep, that works. And he's done. Let's go dump this the long way. And actually, let's turn the... Well, actually, it's 50-50 whether the cultivator would be better on this side or that side. We'll wait till he gets a little closer, then we'll shift him over. Or we'll just put him on pause for a while. Could do that. This little guy's going to take a long time to catch up to him. Try the other right. There we go. I just noticed over there to my left, obstacle this way, between episodes I went and picked up at least one of the conveyors. The other one is a tractor hitch. I took the pickup and it didn't work. So we'll get that someday. Anyway, stretch, sprain the fingers, control I. Which end? Yep, wrong one. I just thought I'd freak him out. Ah, made it. Now he's gonna come down this side. I could try backing up, but that's just a recipe for disaster. I'll turn around. Cruise control this time. Ooh, it's going to be tight. Yeah, we're just about to hit our last pass here on that cultivator. Done. Get out of his way. And I think sit here and wait for the cultivator to come back and then just turn him off for a little while. Sower's going. Yeah, we're not really waiting for anything as far as trying to race out there and do something. I've got 53% of the trailer left, so I've got one more load. We're almost to the end of this field. This took quite a while. It took long enough that I don't think we really need to do this again. We'll stick to things that are a little more automated and less dependent on us being there for every step of the way. Let's see, this guy. Turn it around. That's a shorter run, so he may be able to go over there and come all the way back. And we'll be able to unload him here at this end. You know, that is so close that it might just barely time out. Where's he going? He's going straight all the way to the original end, isn't he? No, he's not. Not depth of field, but the amount of view that I've got in my settings only shows that many sweet potatoes, but it actually goes further back. Okay. Anyways, pop out, hop into here, and let's let her turn it all the way around. She's going to take out that sign, isn't she? If not this time, definitely next time. Yeah, I got to give the county road crew something to do. But we'll let her turn it around, or him. That way it's lined up just right for the next person that we hire. Okay. Beacons are on. And I think we better just make sure he comes to a complete stop. Otherwise, trying to back up with him, that can only go bad. Let's go dump this one. And I'm guessing there's enough hopper there to catch all the rest of that and be done. And for that matter, we could probably go turn the cultivator back on. We just needed that little pause in between. I can't sneak in. Well, that is quite the pile of sugar beets. See if we can kind of round this end off here. Right there. Whoa, I was looking for traffic. Well, I made a mess. But don't worry, little elves come out and put the wheelbarrow back every night, and I'm sure that these will get put back too. All right, what's happening here? Are we full or are we blocked? We are blocked. Okay. Yep, we got a mess going on here. Let's turn this guy around. Too much happening at one choke point. Stop you. Let's see. Jump out. Hire this one. That should free you to finish up. Yep. And looking at the space there, I'm thinking that's only 20 to 30% full. No, not even that. Let's see what happens here. How wide? Now we have all the way there and all the way back yet. Well, I guess we wait. What to do after this? Head over to the grass field, field 11, and do what? We tethered some grass, even though in-game it's only been a couple of hours, but in real world here it's been several days since we've been on this game, so we'll call it dried. So Baylor is already over there. That's about all you can do with the tethered grass is bale it. Well, you could wrap it afterwards. Regular grass and hay will both make silage bales if you choose to. Though the tethering step is not necessary as far as... Oh, I'm watching at the other end over there. They're going to hit each other, aren't they? I think he snuck through in between. But is one going to continue? Yeah, they're both blocked. Okay. It was good while it lasted. We'll reminisce about grass and hay later. Ah, they're so close. Interesting. Both of them have their flashers on now. I'm stuck. Alright, let's unhire. And back up. Just enough. Whoa! Now, did we finish the row? We did. So let's just do this one ourselves. And we gotta get there before he does. So let's see. That one, that one. We good? We're good. Right? Yep, there it is. I think we're both at 6 miles an hour. Let's just see if we can stop him from driving over the very end of the sugar beets over there. Which I will, for the rest of my life, call sweet potatoes. I think it's because they first introduced this in Farming Simulator 2013, I never saw... I have yet to even see words. They only use symbols. And so clear back then, I made the guess that that looked like a sweet potato. I've never, I take it back. Maybe the equipment in some of the descriptions says it's for sweet potatoes, but otherwise when you're looking at the crops, it's only, they only use pictures. They only use graphics. And I missed a couple. Oh well, we'll call this good. Now, race back over here and get him dumped before he runs into us again. The sower is doing fine, though he doesn't have enough reservoir to have enough seed for the entire field. So we'll have to fill that back up again before we take off to work on grass. Let's see, this side? Yeah. Let's get this dumped and then out of the way. Boy, that's bouncy. Right there. Now, in real life, I'm guessing that you would want to put the weight over the axles first, rather than out over the tongue, which just puts all the weight onto the back of the tractor. Alright, so this guy, where to? At the moment, he should be good right here. Neither the sower nor the cultivator will need that space to turn around this time. But we're only going to get one pass at that. He's got to go where? He's going to back up. Okay, I'm going to sneak through. I'm not. I'm going to get out of here. Dancing tractors. Synchronized tractor ballet here. Alright. Let's put this guy over here. And race over, get this out of the way. Alright, let's get this one dumped. That is the end. The sugar beets. Okay, so this guy can be dropped off. We can take the other tractor back, other trailer back, sell it, and pick up the other conveyor. That will make the trip worthwhile. And I'd like two bays next to each other for the two trailers. Or tippers, we'll call it. I guess they're called. I wonder if we can get two in each of these bays. Kinda. Just can't get the tractor in, too. There we go. Oh! Whenever I stand in front of the tractor, everything is backwards to me. I can never get my fingers to... Let me see if I can get this right off to the edge here. There. Yeah, we can get two tippers in this bay. And we'll call that one done. Okay. So, next. The... sugar beet harvester over there. Get that put away, and we'll use this tractor to haul this tipper back. So we'll just park him right there. Let's go get this guy. Sprint out over here. Can't see either of the other two right now. And he's still looking pretty clean. We don't need to give him a bath. So which bay? It was this one. Alright, gotta think here. That's the direction I want. I want to take my time making the turn. We don't come up too short. Yeah, something like that. Now, I need to be able to squeeze in between. Yeah, I do, actually. So I can get back there and get the topper first. So we need this to be more like that. Let's see, this way. So he's going to have to skirt the edge here. Well, that might be a little bit too close. What do you think? We got that? Yeah, I think we got that. Oh, that is tight. What did we hit? Ah, right back there. I'm going to call that good enough. Okay. Now what? I'm thinking that there is time to get to the shop and back before the seed runs out on the sower. Probably going to be wrong, but I think we'll go for that. So this guy goes here. Grab this one. Where are you? There you are. Let's go sell him and pick up the other conveyor. It's probably a more technical term for that. A conveyor belts. Doesn't say. It is the Grimy Quantum. Okay. And he's the one that's not in Noble Green, or Rambler Green. What did Vapa call that? Named a sea moth after me in his Subnautica. Colored it green to match. Helper J has completed their task. I'm guessing that is the cultivator. Yep, all the plowing left to do. Not looking forward to it. Tank is empty. Yep. Missed that one. Oh well, there's still plenty of time, unless we go through a transition. Ah, I forgot about that. Well, we're at least on real time right now, speed 1. So hopefully we can get back and get the job completed before we end up with two different harvest times in the same field. Yeah, it's kind of annoying. But it forces you to do a delay, which gives you time to finish another project. Gives you an excuse to not dive right into the harvesting. But for folks that are new to this, if you take the items you want to sell to the shop, sell them there rather than just do them from the hitting P on your keyboard to bring up the shop remotely, then you'll get a better price for it. I don't know what the difference is. Maybe as much as 20%. This is a long conveyor belt. It's going to be a little tricky to get home. Right about the length of one of the biggest headers. Now, is there a... There's not a quick and easy way to turn this tractor around, huh? Not another pathway. Oh, 3-point turn. We squeeze through there? I think so. Yeah, we'll do that. Alright. Or with this we're selling, $2,500 they're going to give us for 24. And sell. Okay, he's gone. Ah, it just dawned on me. I sold it with the idea of getting another one, but I can't haul that other one back. Alright. That's another trip. But let's get this guy back. Put more seed in the sower. It's kind of fun to use here. Yeah, I was going to demonstrate it, but let's get it home. We'll demonstrate it maybe another episode. It extends out to almost twice as long as this. You change the angle, go up over the top of the side of a tipper, pour it into there. Which I would say we want to get a much bigger tipper before we go to do this. You saw how many trips it took to get that field emptied with the tippers that we've got. Although a train of three or four of those would do the job. That's the way I'm used to doing it. A whole train of smaller ones rather than a couple of massive ones. Let's see. I haven't been in cab for a while. Let's do it this way. Wish you gotta watch out for these guys racing down the road here and making a right turn right in front of you. Crazy drivers out here. At the end of my work day right now, and I'm feeling a little tired. My nose is whistling. Hey, when that comes over the microphone. But when you're tired, you just want to sit back and drive. Don't want to come up with things to say. I can't just make a hard right turn with this thing. I noticed it was rubbing up on the wheel. I'm going to take it in smaller stages. Which is faster? I think I'm hitting right about the middle of the field, so I don't know if either way is faster. Yeah, the other way may have been. No, because the where I'm going to take it is to this side of it, so I guess this was the better way. There's our sower. Take my limousine over there rather than run it. The farmer's limousine. Oh, taxi! That's not what I meant to do. That's what I meant to do. All right, let's get this guy. You're still making dirt. All right, let's get him out of here. Actually, this way. Fertilizer's fine. It's interesting how the fertilizer goes so much further than the seed. And there's the sign. Yep, didn't survive. Alright, now let's see if we can knock the seed off the top of the pile there and onto the ground below. Stacking looked like a great idea at first. Let's get down right there. Okay, I'm up in the air. Okay, so we took that one out and they still didn't topple. Oh, good. Okay, fill up some more. And then C to get out of here so I don't have to have the head bob through the rafters anymore. Let's see, where did the seed end? Right about there. That looks pretty close. Problem is, if you get just a tiny bit off, it'll jump over and start seeding the next row and leaving a gap at this side. So I'm gonna go a little further back this way. Alright, we'll try that one. See how this looks. Of course, I can't get up in the air high enough to see it. That's when I want to roll my mouse and flip out the chainsaw. But it looks pretty good. I think we've got some consistency there, and we didn't leave a gap behind. Okay. Back in here, and what? Let's not back in here. We've got to put him away. Let's put this guy away first, and we'll toggle over to him. Rather than run over to the barn over there, or the shed, and then the lean-to or carport. What do you call this thing? I don't know. And start looking around for the case tractor and scratching my head. That's not the right angle. Right there. Okay. There we are. X. And we're putting him away dirty. 2,300 in wage payments for the last hour. Although at one speed, we got a lot done in the last hour. That's not too bad. I'm guessing that's a trailer of sugar beets, and that's paid for. All right, this guy in here at the edge. Too far. Okay, pull out of that. Pass the wheels. Turn in. Something like that. Yep, that's pretty good. A little further. Alright then. I'm thinking we're free to go work on grass. What do we got going on? Back to our map. Fruit types. So we've got canola going in. Soybean planted. Barley planted. And 12 did need a plowing this time. Okay. So essentially, all three are going to need plowings next time. These are going to come up too. So, one round of plowing coming up. Otherwise, this is seed, fresh seed. So, this is the first stage of growth over here. So, we've got quite a bit of time coming up before all of this is ready to do something with. So, the next several episodes, we're going to be able to do other things. Good. All right, that's what I wanted to know. Let's go play with grass and hay and silage and all that good stuff. Or at least get a good start for next episode. Oh, there is another step to do over here. Okay, next episode we need to get in and fertilize all this. Yeah. Can we do that now? I think we do that now. So next time can be just field 11 and doing the grass over there. So let's put a spraying on all this and we'll kind of round out the farm this episode and be done with it. Though this tractor is quite overkill for that. Now what is that one in the back? That's the tedder, isn't it? Oh, that is the weeder. Oh. That's right. We could run the weeder right now. Let's go do that. Is there room to get me in there? It looks awfully tight. Nah, I guess we can. Barely. Hello, beam. Okay, where's my hitch symbol? I hate looking there and looking down there at the box and looking there. There it is. Now, can I get you out of here? Let's see, if I were to take you this way, that will fit. Okay. Yeah, we haven't done this for a while. Now, X, what does that look like? Oh, yeah, he was quite impressive. Let's get past these obstacles first. There we are. And this will count as a fertilizing layer. That's right. Okay. Now, if I were to do that... No, it doesn't lift up and down like the sprayer. So V and B doesn't do anything. It just starts it up. Okay, let's do this. There. 7 miles an hour is all that I get. That's floored. But it's a nice wide width, so 6 passes maybe, and we're good. Alright, so Klaus was saying that, at least on his version of the game, let's see, let me hit which button? That one. Yep. That silaging grass works fine at the biogas plant, but he seemed to have some problems doing it over at the cow silos, the cow pasture. So we'll have to try both of those and ourselves and see just what's going on there. It seems odd that one would work and one wouldn't, so maybe it's a defect with the map here that hasn't been corrected yet. If a process works in one place, I can't come up with any logical reason why they would distinguish one place from another. Now, is there any reason why I gotta pick this thing up? Not really. I have no problem with pulling the weeds out of the grass here. We'll just take it around like so. Now, if I had the steering wheel hooked up, I could just make a partial turn and figure out where that is and make a nice perfect 180 all the way around. But the keyboard, it's all or nothing. We're halfway through. Nice. That field over there is a little bit bigger, so it'll take a couple extra passes. So it looks like 6 passes in here and 8 in the other one. After this, I think I am going to dive back into Transport Fever and give that another try. At least spend a little more time creating test videos with Bandicam and the various codecs, just make sure that everything is working right. And then record episode 1 for the third time? Fourth time? That got a little frustrating. Hopefully it works this time. Wish Fraps would record the mouse pointer. I like Fraps better than anything. Except for little things like this, it just works. Very few choices, so there's very few ways to mess up. You just do it. Is that gonna finish that last row? Or am I gonna have to go back for a sliver? If so, I might just leave that sliver. What's it gonna do? It's really close. Alright, we're just gonna split the difference and be thankful. Concentrating, watching both edges and working back and forth, make sure I don't veer. I think we actually got it all. I didn't see any light brown marks behind. Alright, I'm going to cut straight up into here and finish this one. I think that'll be an episode. Already in the 50-minute range. There. How How's the sower doing over there? Nope, he's out of line of sight. So what is that called when you when things start to render at a certain distance away from you? It's not field of view. Distance to render? DTR? What? No, it's three symbols. Three letters. It's an acronym. I don't think it's FOV. I don't know. I know that most games I set it to its max, but this one doesn't seem to indicate what max is. It's a percentage. You know, I know I've got them all set at, oh, at least 200%, some of them 300%, and there's various ones in this game. So different types of items that you want to come into view, from crops to, I think, ground textures to water to what have you. It's like the textures for the field over there that we just did are all down to their lowest level. Over there, field 15, I think it is. It's just coming into view now, about halfway through. I'm trying to do that and watch this edge over here. Try not to miss anything. So it's circle around you. You can see the curved path over there in that corner, far corner. So I'm at 250 to 300% on that. I don't know if that goes to 1,000 or if it goes to 300 or what. I don't know what the max is to know what percentage I'm really at. All I know is most games I've always taken that to the max and my video card has done just fine. I'm running a GTX NVIDIA 770. I was doing the 560 Ti before this, right when I first started the my channel, and it did a great job. Went ahead and went to the 770 and put the 560 in the other computer that my family uses. I took this one out of the family room to create the studio, so I kind of took all the games away from the house by doing that. So I built another gaming computer. It was kind of a medium quality one, so that everyone else, the kids, could still enjoy games without having to make an appointment to use this one. This one is used most of my free time. So the 770 does a pretty good job. I'd love to do this in cab, but I know I'd never have a chance at doing it accurately. Constantly staring at the tip of the weeder down there. Which kind of blinds you to what a straight row is. You're not looking at the big picture. I'm just concentrating on one little point and trying to maintain it. So I think this frees us up to next time just deal with field 11. Which we've been trying to get back to for quite some time now. Get that done. Maybe come back over here and spray these one more time as they hit the next growth stage. After that, probably stick up another pole. See what we want to dive into next time while we're waiting for field 11 to grow again. Though somewhere in between both of those, I'm going to have to plow some fields and build up a bank account so we can buy more equipment or more livestock or whatever we choose to do. What do you think? Two more passes? It looks that way, or one and a half. Okay, you're good there. Where's the sower? Yeah, it may have even given me a message already that he's done. I didn't notice one. They slip past me all the time. I'm not looking up in the top corner. I'm looking... Ah, there it is. I'm looking down there at the tip of the weeder. My whole world right now is on a little 1-inch by 1-inch square on the screen. Getting a little dizzy doing it. Okay, we've got a little bit of leeway here, so I'm going to let him drift into that a little bit right there. Whew, so much better. Less stress in here. Although I can't tell where I'm at. A little too far. Let's get back over there. Yep, I feel blind in there. I can't. I've got nothing to compare to. There. Otherwise, I think we're done with this one. Just got to put the sower away and put this guy away. Yeah, so I think I'm going to call this one done. This has been Noble Rambler. I thank you guys for watching. Hit the subscribe down there if you would, and the thumbs up, and I appreciate it. Catch you next time, folks. Bye-bye.